सही राम से।
साईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ओम साईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ओम साईश्वराय विद्महे सत्यदेवाय धीमहि तन्नः सर्व प्रचोदयात्। ओम साईराम एवरीवन, एंड माय हम्बल प्रणाम्स टू स्वामी फॉर बीइंग मर्सिफुल एंड काइंड, ब्रिंगिंग अस what I would call gems, who are fortunate to have come across him in their lifetimes, who have inspired many in different ways. And today we have someone with us who I would say inspired a lot of us growing up. I would say it was a trio then, it's a duo now, but their way of singing would evoke the divinity in each one of us, because they were resonating their bhakti every time they sang. And we are talking of none other than the Eradi brothers. In the early 1940s, the Eradi brothers, Krishnadas, Haridas uncle, and Shivadas, were born and brought up in Calicut. They belonged to a very spiritual family and were introduced to bhajans by their parents at the tender age of 5 by their late father, Sri V.V. Eradi, who was a direct disciple of Swami Shivananda of Rishikesh. In addition to singing bhajans regularly at home, they would attend sampradaya bhajans conducted by the local community. And the Eradi brothers received their first divine darshan of our beloved Lord Bhagwan in the year 1916, Puttaparthi. And for those of you who have followed that beautiful article, how Kasturi uncle would come and talk to them and ask who they are and how they got to sing, that beautiful episode has been captured in Radio Sai. And in 1967, which is the same episode, Swami blessed them by visiting their late brother, Justice Eradi of Kerala High Court, visiting his home and staying with them. And in 1976, they also had the good fortune of another divine visit of Swami to their home in Calicut with Swami's students. 1967 was a turning point in their lives. As I said, this is the incident that has been captured in Radio Sai beautifully, where they had the opportunity to sing in front of Swami, and Swami showered his divine love on them on many other occasions throughout. And if there is an epitome of people who do not need a mic to sing, these are the brothers, where the resonance in their voices would, as I said, evoke the divinity and everyone who is part of a bhajan. Our speaker for today is the eldest of the brother, Sri Krishnadas Eradi, who was blessed by Swami to be the state convener for 14 years up to 1997, and was one of the key persons involved in spreading the love and teachings of Bhagwan throughout the state of Kerala through various activities undertaken by the state organization. As will by Swami, Sri Krishnadas uncle also played a vital role in transforming bhajan singing in Kerala by first forming the state bhajan group and then later expanding the same to district and samiti levels. I would only I don't have words to describe, because this whole satsang series, there are a lot of people whom we would have heard, we would have not met. And as the beautiful family of Sai that we are all part of, Swami connects the dots, and today is yet another connecting the dot, because I grew up always hearing people talk of the Iradi brothers and bringing tape recordings here and there. And today I'm blessed and fortunate to have them right with us. And I'm looking forward to hearing you, Uncle. And it's all yours now. Praying to Swami to be with us throughout the satsang. Uncle, you have to unmute yourself, Uncle. You are muted, so you have to unmute yourself. Okay.
Sairam, you are hearing now.
Yes, Uncle. Yes.
Yeah. Sairam, Kodi pranams at the lotus feet of our loving Swami. Dear sisters and brothers, today I consider very happy to be with you all and have some satsang. The whole life is dedicated, as Swami expects, to have satsang as much as possible satsang. Then through bhajans, we are all grown up, as Mr. Venkat told. We are all from the childhood itself, we are all grown with bhajans from the childhood. And first, I thought I will just talk about how we came into fold of Swami. Actually, we were having business in Calicut, timber business, rice business, and also we have our own office at our house. And one fine day in the afternoon, when my father was entering to the office after his lunch, one of the staff was reading a book. So casually, my father was asking, "What is the book you are reading?" Then he told, "It's Satyam Shivam Sundaram. It's Satya Sai Baba's book." Then actually, we have not heard at that time. My father has not heard about it. So he immediately had given that book to my father. And father has gone through the entire book, and he had a desire that we should visit Puttaparthi. You know, our family, right from the very beginning, 1942 to 1951, we were conducting Akhand Bhajan with the local Brahmin community. And Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. That is only one bhajan, 24 hours. It was going on in full swing for 24 hours, full swing. And our background itself is to hear a lot of Bhagavata discourses and other things. So we were very much interested to involve in the bhajans. And due to that, we have become the bhajan leaders in 50s also, in several places. Saradamat, Abhedananda, our guru is Abhedananda Bharati. And through that, you know, we had a lot of opportunities to participate bhajan, to sing bhajan, to lead bhajan. And during 60s, early 60s, 63, 63, first visit, Swami came to Calicut. And engineering college, one Mr. Rao, Swami was visiting to his house. And Mr. Rao wanted us to do the bhajan when Swami comes. So that was our first opportunity to sing in Calicut in Mr. Rao's house, Principal Rao's. And, you know, after that bhajan, you know, it is just went on like that. Then the second bhajan, my youngest brother and my other brother also were in Palghat. When Swami came to Palghat, that was a time which they got a chance to sing Chitta Chora Yashoda Ekebal in front of Swami. Swami liked very much. Swami also told after the bhajan, why can't you make an alap also before starting? So we have started alap from there. From that day onwards, you know, we have started alap. To our good fortune, till his last breath, whenever we are visiting Puttaparthi, Swami used to demand from the throne, Chitta Chora, like that, you know. So every time, almost every time, 90%, Swami used to ask us to sing Chitta Chora, Yashoda Kebal. So the thing is, the first visit when we have come to Puttaparthi in 1960, we were just there. The only thing is, you know very well, those days, absolutely no comfort, no convenience, nothing was there. No, we had to lie down in veranda. We had to keep our samans and all inside ashram somewhere and all. We had to go for a Chitravati river for the morning bath and other things and all. That is the thing. So it is really a different type of this thing which we felt actually. We were there for 2 days and came back. But we were very much attracted the bhajan. Those days afterwards only we came to know that Rajareddy was singing and Lady Sahib Vijaya was singing. Those days we don't know one gentleman singing and one lady singing with discipline. And the singing, that vibration, you know, that we liked very much. Actually, from that year onwards or 61 onwards, three of us started coming for all the functions like Shivaratri, Dasara, and Swami's birthday. That was our beginning. And 1967, my brother, late brother, Justice Airadi, his house Swami visited and stayed for 3 days. And all the 3 days, morning and evening, bhajan was ours actually. And all the, with every morning and evening, some public functions will be there, either for advocates or judges or general public or some press reporters. You know, so many public, small gatherings will be there. 2 days, there was a big gathering. The last day in the, I don't remember, it was a con. Town hall. In the evening time, it's a town hall. And another also in a plain place, in the open place. Nearly, I think, some 5,000 people were gathering at that time in 67. And after the third bhajan, third day bhajan, the next day morning, Swami was leaving. And Swami was very much happy. He came and hugged the three of us after the evening, after the bhajan, and told that Puttaparthi ki va, like that, we had from the house itself, we had interviews and all. And next program was Dasara at Puttaparthi. Swami told on the first day itself, called Kasturi and told that three brothers are coming from Kerala, ask them to start leading bhajan here. So Kasturi was searching who are the three brothers from Kerala and all. So we have not even started on the first day. We used to go on the third day where that yajna starts. So third day, 7 days yajna is there, you know. And only at that time, once again. So after we reached the Puttaparthi, somebody told that Kasturi was inquiring about us, that we went to Kasturi. Then we told, we are three brothers from Kerala. So then Kasturi told, I had to find out from Swami whether Swami meant we three or any other three brothers. And, that confirmation, we got it the same evening. Next day onwards, we have started singing bhajan. During the first trip and second trip and all, see, we are all Krishna bhaktas actually. So it was not digesting for us, you know, to accept somebody else in at our heart in the place of Krishna, to somebody else to come. So I was just thinking myself, we have to get some proof that Swami should make us understand that he himself is also Krishna, or incarnation of Krishna. And that day evening, I was attending bhajan, evening bhajan. So my thinking was whether the same Krishna like that, you know. See, all of a sudden, I am not seeing Swami during the bhajan time. Swami slowly turned out to Krishna form. And the hair and all, you know, it is just like we are seeing that just like Krishna only, just for two, three minutes, you know. I have seen Krishna and tears have started pouring. Making us understanding that both are same. So that day onwards only, you know, our inner faith have improved. And see, I got a in the meantime, I'll just tell you one thing. Because of the due to age, I am not able to express myself the apt word. Please bear with me. Sometimes, you know, I wanted to express something, you know, but I am not able to. Getting for the last 1 year, some problem is just, so I was avoiding as much as possible this type of, because then I'm not able to express myself. So if there is anything going wrong, the second point, you know, if I'm talking something, I will just deviate from that point to some other point. I'll get something, then I'll go to the second point, then third point. Finally, I myself will forget from where I have started. In those things, you please bear with me if I'm talking. So that was the bhajan we have started singing from 1967 Dasara onwards. And we were not knowing the rules and regulations and all. The next function was Shivaratri. Shivaratri, my youngest brother Shivadas came on the previous day. We reached only the next day. So he doesn't know what is the rule and all. Of course, we sang the Dasara time, we sang. But he didn't get seat, so he was in the last row of Mandir, I'm talking. He was in the last row. He was sitting in the last row. And Swami came through the back door. And Swami saw Shivan was sitting in the last row. So he immediately caught hold of his ear and made him stand. And, you know, with the same pose, you know, he has not left out of this thing. He just took it in the middle path, you know, took him to the front and Ella Vati Sholanama Padradhake Pad, like that. So at that time, you know, we came to know, you know, we can come and sing and, you know, sit at the front and sing and all. And during the, I mean, years, whenever Swami gives interview, Swami used to talk why bhajan, what for bhajan, and what is the importance of bhajan, like that. So why bhajan, what for bhajan? See, you will, those days, there is only one program. Morning bhajan, evening bhajan. That's all. No other, no organization. Nothing was there. Then slowly, you know, afterwards only organization started, then Bal Vikas, then so many things, seva activities, so many. Now it is, spread like anything. But even after having all those activities, you would have observed that Swami has not left the morning and evening bhajan. Even today, it is like that. Because Swami was giving more importance for the bhajan. Why? That's what Swami was telling one day. See, when you are hearing somebody is giving lecture, your mind may deviate. So many times. Sometimes, you feel sleepy. Sometimes, your mind will deviate. You will not be able to understand the entire thing. But when the bhajan starts, Omkaram and bhajan starts, you are completely concentrated. All the devotees are forgetting everything. They will be having some personal problems, official problems, regarding health problems. So many things will be there. But everything you will forget, is it not? When the bhajan starts, you are forgetting. Swami was telling, devotees may be thinking those who are sitting in the veranda are the luckiest people. People who are sitting in the normal, they are not getting interviews, they are not calling, they are not, Swami is not, it's not like that. Swami was telling, this is the thing Swami was telling, when you forget yourself during bhajan time, at that time, I am coming every individual's heart, giving interview, transforming every one of us, but you are not aware of that. I am giving interview to everybody. This is what Swami told. Previously, we were also out, sitting in the common place. But afterwards, 70s and all, we have started sitting as per Swami's command, we were sitting in veranda and all. But we came to know that those who are sitting in veranda is having more problems because, there are more restrictions. You cannot just take your hand or give letter, or you cannot just talk like that, Highly disciplined. Swami was telling, people who are in veranda, they should be our model for everybody. So that discipline is strictly maintained. Swami have to come to you, ask you, what is the matter? Enna samacharam, something. Then only we are supposed to talk. Then only we can. So outside when we are sitting, we could have done anything. So when we came inside, then only we came, we could have sit outside. Then, you will have more opportunity to talk Swami and all. So that is a thing with. So this interview, Swami is giving interview only through bhajan. Bhajan means, this is the most important thing. Bhajan is the most important thing. Swami always says, once Swami was talking about the combination of Shruti when we were talking. Swami asked, where is the combination when you are singing? Raja Reddy sings in one pancham. Immediately, Vijaya will sing three pancham. I'll ask to take 4.5 pancham. Or Mohan Rao used to sing 5 pancham and all. So there is no combination. Combination should be there. Either madhyam or pancham like that. So you may think then, how you will get all the shrutis? See, in different bhajans, different shruti. Some is in one pancham, some is in 1.5 pancham, 2 pancham, 2.5 pancham, in that way. Then if you wanted to have that combination of shruti, how you will get? Swami himself was answering, 1 madhyam 4, 4 madhyam 6.5, 6.5 madhyam 2.5, 2.5 madhyam 5.5, 5.5 madhyam 1.5, 1.5 madhyam 4.5, 4.5 madhyam 7. Which Shruti is not there when you're taking Madhyam Shruti? So that is the combination why Swami was insisting. Actually, from that day onwards till today, we always observe the. Now, students knows very well. They will ask us, what is the bhajan, what is the Shruti you are singing? So they will sing in the same Shruti on the previous thing because they know that, will not deviate from the Shruti. I was telling, this is Swami's instruction to us. So we'll have to have combination of, even during Onam time, when we were getting the opportunity to Kerala people to lead the bhajan, I was very particular that combination of Shruti is a must actually. And we were following that either one or four and four, even the lady side also, they can, you know, normally our bhajans, whatever Shruti we are singing, the Madhyam Shruti will be suitable for the ladies. So in that way, we used to adjust. And Swami likes that combination should be there. In that way, he was telling. Another thing we'll have to understand, in 1982, one day we got a circular. My parents have shifted, as per his command, to Puttaparthi. In 1980, Swami asked me to bring the parents. And, you know, I was thinking at that time, 1980, my father was 82 at that time. So I was thinking, and those days there is no much convenience, comforts. I was thinking myself during that fraction of a second I'm talking, during the interview. Suppose I bring the parents at that age here, that nothing. Then immediately Swami patted on my shoulder. I will look after 100 times much better than you look after your parents. What more assurance we want? Actually, I started crying. And that word, you know, until their last breath, Swami was looking after their complete, everything Swami was looking after them. And during that time, 1982, 81, we have shifted. I mean, my parents have shifted to Puttaparthi. 82, I think, 82, early 82 or something. We got a circular from Kudumbarao. He was a secretary at that time. That Swami wanted to address everybody in the mandir. 3 o'clock, Swami will come. So all are requested to be in the mandir by 2:30 p.m. Exactly 3 o'clock, Swami came. And Swami, as usual, Swami asked to close down all the windows. And at that time, you know, hardly 300, 350 staff, that's all, during those period. And Swami told Kudumbarao to talk. Then Kudumbarao started talking. So many devotees have come and settled over here from different states, living their comforts and convenience. And sometimes, you know, even family also. Family will be in their native place and they'll be working and serving Swami. Swami is too happy and all. So much he was telling. Then afterwards, he told, but he's not very happy with one thing which you people are doing here. You are making new friends. You are making loose talks. You're making, see, here you came here, I have selected, Swami has selected here to transform yourself and go to a different level of spirituality. But you're again making that, Swami is not. So you're not serving for Swami as per his expectation. That's what he was the last. Immediately, Swami told, stop, I'll talk. Swami told, whatever he has talked is correct. But the last sentence, you are not serving, you are not doing service for Swami. Swami doesn't need any service from anybody. Swami was telling. Swami told, I don't need anybody. I'm giving you opportunity to do seva. I'm giving you an opportunity to have an organization. Then through organization, you are getting a lot of chances to do. An example, Swami told, Sri Rama knows Pattabhishekam is next day. Swami is selling that way. Next day is Pattabhishekam. Sri Rama knows very well that Pattabhishekam is not going to have. He has to go to forest. Everything Sri Rama knows. Then, you know, in the Ramayana Katha, you know, he has gone to this thing, he lost to Sita. And Swami was telling, right from squirrels to Hanuman, Swami has given chances, Sri Ramaswamy have given chances to do service. Sri Ramaswamy need only a fraction of a second to get back the Sita. Swami is telling, he knows that who is going to take, where she is, everything. But as a human being, as if he doesn't know, he is giving chances to all the devotees to do seva. And like that, moksham was, so many devotees have got moksham through that. And like that, I am giving you an opportunity to do selfless seva for yourself, not for me. In fact, I am having 100 headaches because you people are here and doing some wrong thing. That's what Swami is telling. Swami is telling, even American president wanted to become American president, he has to get vote. I don't want any vote. In this, I don't want any vote. Because I am more, and about miracles also Swami was telling at that time. See, what is miracle? Not merely making some vipudi or Krishna vigraha or Ganapati vigraha is not like that. Miraculously, Swami was telling, in a day, how much time I am spending with you people, Swami was telling. See, these are all the things which we have to understand. Swami told, morning I am coming for the interview. Hardly 1.5 hours or 2 hours, then half an hour bhajan, then I'm going inside. Evening also, some 2.5 hours. So hardly 5 hours, I'll be coming down from the upstairs. Out of 24 hours, 5 hours, I'm with you people. Even after in the 5 hours, how much I'm talking to people? No. From where you have come? When did you come? Normal questions, is it not? How many you are, from which country? Everything Swami knows. But why Swami is telling? Swami is telling, when I am talking something to you people, you will be in the ecstasy for months together. Oh, Swami, talk to me. Swami, see, Swami's darshan, just like walking, Swami smiled at me, Swami just blessed me, Swami talked to me. In that way, you know, people are in the ecstasy for months together. Only for that purpose, what I am talking, when are you coming, or when did you come, or how many people are there, in which country, that's all. No other talks. Not only in India, all over the world, everything goes very well. Sitting in the upstairs, alone, for 19 hours, everything goes very well. Swami is not traveling everywhere, is it not? Everything goes, and devotees are increasing multiples. You know, it is increasing like anything. Everybody knows. In 1960, how many devotees were there? In 1970, how much it has increased? 80, 90, 2000, like that, it is increasing. But Swami's activities have not changed. Even in the latest days also. Swami is mingling with us only some 4-5 hours, not more than that. So sitting in the upstairs and managing everything, that is miracle. That's what Swami told. So you don't have to talk. Even as a district president or state president or anything like that, you don't have to talk much. The thing is, Swami always says, love, 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 love. That is the only thing. See, love has got a tremendous power. Love has got a tremendous power. If you start loving, without any this thing. Now, what happens, you know, in our, this thing, we always, when we are talking too much, you know, so many ideas will come, so many thoughts will come, and your brain will just go like that. It's not like that. If you're just keeping quiet, like Swami, just try. That's why olden days, my father and all, you know, every monthly, one day, he will be in Mavanam and all. So many people, one day complete Mavanam, he will not see anybody, he will not talk to anybody, he will not mingle with anybody. Lot of power. He'll be in the puja room and he'll be sitting only. That power. So Swami is doing 365 days like that actually. So that love make lot of miracles in the world. So that in that way only we'll have to come. We'll have to come down to that level. We have to come to that level. So in the meantime, I'll tell some of my personal experience also. See, I was working in Madras in 1969 onwards, I was in Madras. And 74, I got a promotion and transferred to Tuticorin. And I have to go to Bellary. In fact, at that time, I was having liver problem. I was staying with my sister, elder sister. So she used to look after me very well, without oil, without this thing. So when I got this, I had to join Bellary within 10 days or something like that, my boss was telling. So I just requested him, I'll go to Puttaparthi, get blessings from Swami. Then I have to go to Calicut, get blessings from parents. Then within 10 days, I will reach Bellary. But at the same time, I was thinking myself, how can I travel with this? If you go out, you will not get without oil, without very difficult. And Puttaparthi also is only one South Indian canteen where those days, very much chilli, Andhra people, chilli, oil, everything is there. But I came here. I came to Puttaparthi, reached in the evening. Next day morning, I was in the darshan place I was sitting. Swami came and reached to me. And the first question Swami asked me, when are you going back? See, normally, nobody will ask, suppose I am coming to your house and when are you going? See, in that way, this is very, I was saying, Swami, I want to go back tomorrow itself. Then immediately Swami made me, tomorrow, like that, he just, pretending he was just, no, Swami, whenever Swami is. See, normally those days, when we get permission from Swami, then only we will go. Even for all the functions, we have to get direct permission from Swami, then only we will go. But this, when Swami asked, because this time I wanted to go back, and those days there is no phone, nothing is there. I had to go back to Calicut, get from there also, 2 days it will take, then coming back to Madras, then take, lot of steps. So next day itself I had to go, only get blessed. But Swami told, okay, so romba sandoshan, like that. Then, I was... Swami, I thought, tomorrow Swami may talk something. 1 day, 2 day, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, it has gone. I forget. I thought, I would have lost because, those days I cannot just, there is no mobile phone. So I'll send a telegram unexpectedly written here in that way. And 5 days, 6 days, it was going on. Swami was keeping me. Swami will enjoy our bhajan morning and evening, but afterwards, during darshan time, he pretends that he has not seen me in that way. Like that, it has gone 10 days. 10 days, 10th day, I just gone to Kasturi and told my practical difficulties. This is the thing. 10th day, I'm supposed to join in Bellary. And the first day it has happened like that. Now Swami is not talking to me. You please, on behalf of me, you please get permission like that. Immediately Kasturi told, you only assured to Swami that you will go after getting permission from Swami. And now you are asking me to mediate in that. Swami will give left and right to me. You don't bother. There will be some meaning. When nothing will happen, everything will be all right. You don't want to, but I cannot talk like that. 12th day, I have written a letter. Please ask me to get out from Puttaparthi. That's a letter I have written. I wanted to give to Swami. That's the same word I have to. Please ask me to go out from here. But Swami accepted my letter. Go in, Swami told. That is interview room. I am asking, go out. Swami said, go in. This was And, you know, this was in 1973. And Swami was talking. At that time, I was telling Swami about liver complaint. And I have not talked fully. Liver, I'm not like that. Immediately, Swami told, chup, I'll tell you. Swami told the entire history. See, at that time, our Ramani's father, now the present All India deputy, or his father, Dr. Nagarajan. Swami always called him as Dr. Nagarajan. Nagarajan was so close to me. So he has introduced one doctor, and doctors was giving medicine, injection and all at that time. Everything Swami told, Nagarajan's name, doctor's name, medicine name, the injection what I am taking, everything Swami told. And Swami just materialized Vibhuti and gave it to me. So I thought, you know, I'll just keep it because I am going to Calicut. I'll give little to my parents and all. Swami told, no, you take fully. At that time itself. So I've just taken. While I was taking, Swami told, no more liver complaint. Swami told. See, 73 to 2021, whenever I am having the usual checkup and all, liver is perfectly all right till today. I was not having any problem. Just materialized Vibhuti and given that, you know, I was perfectly all right. But same time, I was having some stomach problem and all. Next time when I came, I told Swami, I'm having always stomach problem. Adu onnodu family property vechiko. Like that Swami told. This is your family property, this stomach problem. You keep it with you like that. Even today, I'm suffering from the stomach, this thing. See, something, you know, why Swami is in a different way, you know, to devotees. See, for my youngest brother, he was having cancer. Swami only told about the cancer and all. So many devotees Swami has given back the life. But my youngest brother, you know, after Swami told about this cancer, you know, he lived another 2 months or 3 months. That's all. In 86. We don't know what is the reason for that and all. So liver, Swami wanted to keep it all right, make it all right. But stomach, you know, it was going on. And actually, the story doesn't end. I gone back with a lot of reluctance. I wanted to go to my boss room and all, you know. Then boss was telling, okay. Then I told me, these are all happened. These are all. I reached only after 2 weeks. Boss told, it's all right. Okay, no problem. Then I came out. But he has not told me when I have to go again and all. So it was going 1 month and all. Swami asked me to bring my parents and brothers again on the next Onam. This has happened in, I think, June or July. September is Onam. So within 2 months, you know, June, I think this has happened in June or something like that. And that also I've told my boss. Because how do I get leave and all to, because 2 weeks I have already taken. Boss told me, no, you can go. So I got the leave. I've taken my parents, my brothers. We are gone 1 week. Onam we have celebrated. And while taking permission, Swami told, Dasaraki varaya, like that he asked. Swami varan, Swami. Yeah, then he turned to my father and told, actually, last month, avane pandanaal inge vichathu. Leave it in the Vanda Puri Lata Vanda. And illa Swami Varan Swami. Swami is asking Varaya like that, you know. See, what more you want, actually. And you know, again I came back. The thing is, I have relieved, I was not having any work in the office these 2 months. Only one work, taking salary on the first, every first. That is only work. But boss is not talking when I have to go indoor. So I used to come to the office. Then again, after Onam, we came and Swami told to come for Dasara. I told him, Dasara, Swami asked me to for 9 days. Oh, you can go like that. Again, Dasara. After Dasara, Swami came. Next month, birthday, where are the Trima? Like that. Ama Swami, Varan Swami, like that. So again, see, like that it has gone. Almost every month, I was spending nearly 10 days to 14 days without any work. And boss also was not bothered about it. And finally, 1974, in the month of May, he called me and gave me one cover. It was a flight, this thing. You have to go to Cochin and take charge of manager there in Cochin instead of Bellary. So till that time, Bellary number two was, because from Bellary, manager has already gone to Goa. Goa meant, you know, in that way, shuffling was there. But I couldn't go. The next man was managing, acting. So the Cochin man was transferred to Bellary. And I came to Cochin, my own native place. So I was so happy. So till some 5-6 months, I was not having any work without accepting any, I mean, this salary. That's all. This is the thing which Swami's miracles we can't, you know. After reaching Kerala only, you know, the organization and everything, you know, I could, involve more in the organization from 1980 onwards. You know, they put me as a state convener, concentrating in improving the bhajan standard, then spiritual sadhana, so many things. You know, Swami has made me as an instrument. And most fortunately, every Onam, we had the golden opportunity to have our own Veda Parayanam, bhajan, everything, 3 days. First one day, I mean, during the first 4-5 years, you know, is only one day. Then afterwards, you know, it was increased to 3 days. So 3 days we were getting the chance of singing bhajan and all. And it has become an international function. This Onam has become an international function. Another one incident. Whenever I'm having some major problem, something, you know, I'll just run to Puttaparthi. And those days, that accessibility to Swami to talk the problem and Swami will solve the problem in that way. So once I reached Puttaparthi, I was sitting in the veranda. So next to me, who is sitting in the veranda, he told, you know, today, I don't think only bhajan will be nearly a group of American ladies have gone inside. Swami called them inside. And, you know, very difficult, you know, afterwards, you know, during bhajan time only make up. It has happened like that. Next day morning also, the same group Swami called. Next day morning. Next day evening also, the same group Swami called them. The American group, ladies, only ladies. And, you know, we were thinking, we didn't get 2-3 days, you know, we didn't get anything. Afterwards, along with the ladies, one doctor also was called from India, one doctor also. And from that doctor, I came to know what was happening in that 3 days. Actually, these ladies were very rich. We can see, you know, from the face itself, you know, very rich people. Their work is to do selfless service in America. Because, you know, America, our, like in India, sorry, there is no, I mean, that much relation between father, mother, between children, parents, wife and husband. So much problems are there in other countries and all. So the 25 people, almost 25 people, are involving wherever the problems are, you know, they are involving and solving the problems. This doctor was narrating to us this, actually why Swami has called for 3 days continuously. And, you know, there's a major problem in a society, in a big place. And all the 25 people assembled together in one house. And they have just starting the conversation. At that time, somebody knocked the door. So one lady opened the door. They saw 5 feet 3 inches, one gentleman with gown, with the thing, is coming inside. They don't know who is he. He was sitting. He just gone and sat one place. Nobody knows who is he. And Swami started about all the problems which they are facing. And Swami told how to solve. See, it will take 3 days to solve the entire problem. Tomorrow when you are going, how you have to deal with those people, everything Swami told. And without waiting, Swami just went out also after this thing. They don't know who is that. Then next day, they have gone. Whatever they got the instructions from Swami, they have done like that. And, you know, it is little piece of mind and all, came back, nothing, sorted out at all. Second day also, Swami came when they were all assembled. Swami told, see, today, further instructions I will give you, that way you have to go. Like that 3 days, Swami has said. So the third day, one lady asked, who are you, from where you are coming? What is your name and all? Swami told, I don't have any name and all. And I am not belongs to one place. I am everywhere. But if you want to see me, you come to India. Like that. Swami left. Swami has not told, I don't have any specific name and all. Whoever calls, I'll be there. Then, after 3 years only, they could come. Because, you know, they had a lot of work to be done. And after 3 years, after having this thing, they came 3 years. Swami, at that time, Swami told, you hosted me 3 days and I'll host you 3 days here in Puttaparthi. In that word only, Swami made him. The thing is, what I'm trying to say, they are doing selfless service. Wherever anybody is doing selfless service, need not be in the name of Satya Sai organization, need not be in the name of Chinmayananda or Hare Krishna or Haridas Singh. God is there along, always. You don't have to invite Swami America, or you don't have to Swami. They have not invited Swami. Swami himself has reached, is it not? So we will all think, you know, so we have to invite Swami. Sometimes jokingly, Swami, you know, you have not called me, that is why I have not come. Sometimes Swami will joke. But that is only joking. This is a clear incident that nobody needs to invite Swami to our own houses. Swami is all. Whenever we are doing selfless service, whenever we are transforming ourselves by doing japa or veda or bhajan or anything, definitely Swami will come to us, rescue us, giving us all the help. That assurance, that not only in the form of Swami, because, you know, for my mother, we are all Krishna Bhaktas. Swami told, Vanaka Ade Puru. Krishna Ade Puru. Swami has materialized a Krishna, Venu, Krishna to my mother. And my mother was chanting only Krishna, 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 Vanaka Ade Puru. See, you would have observed, you know, we three are singing more Krishna bhajans than the other bhajans. Krishna bhajans only. So, Swami is not, Swami never says that we should pray Swami or we should not go anywhere else or something like that. You know, wherever you are praying, your god, your favorite goddess, god, Ayyappa, Buruga, so that will do. There, Swami will reach, or in that form, in Krishna form, you will get rescued, definitely. This is the main thing which we'll have to learn. I think now, 6 o'clock, I was telling, 6 o'clock, is it all right? If you permit, I will sing one or two bhajans and...
Uncle, we have all the time to listen, because whatever I can tell you so far that you've been touching on, I keep telling everybody that each week we get a customized prescription from Swami. So most of whatever you're talking is like a customized prescription for many of us. So if you feel like talking, go ahead. I'm not going to say talk so long, sing so long. It's your...
No, we will continue. We will continue okay. in another day. I as I told you, my brother is very kind enough to accept for the next Sunday. He will give he will talk much better than me, actually. So
please sing, uncle, whatever you feel comfortable. There's nothing, it's your call. What Swami wills is what we are going to hear.
Yeah, one or two songs I will I'll sing. Then, you know, we'll... मन में मेरे गोपाला श्याम राधे नंदलाला, मन में मेरे गोपाला श्याम राधे नंदलाला, श्याम गोपाला साई गोपाला, श्याम गोपाला साई गोपाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, यशोद तनया गोपाला, यशोद तनया गोपाला, यदुकुल तिलका गोपाला, यदुकुल तिलका गोपाला, रथालोला गोपाला, रथालोला गोपाला, रासविलोला गोपाला, रासविलोला गोपाला, मन में मेरे गोपाला श्याम राधे नंदलाला, श्याम गोपाला साई गोपाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, वृंदावन के नंदलाला, शोध तनया गोपाला, यदुकुल तिलका गोपाला, शोध तनया गोपाला, यदुकुल तिलका गोपाला, राधालोलाम गोपाला, रासविलोला राम रासवीलोला गोपाला मन में मोहे रे गोपाला श्याम राधे नंदलाला Sairam, I thought I'll sing Chittachora where always Swami asked me to sing. Is it all right?
Yeah, sing Chittachora. I also have a request. Chittaraja yeah. also, if possible. Chittaraja also. Chittaraja also. I don't know whether...
Chittaraja, actually, next is... week, my brother
next
will
week.
Sing.
Okay, it's brother's song. Yeah. Okay.
He's a master. Oh, see, even though we are singing together, Chittachora, of course, I'll sing. I'll take head of that. And Chittaraja, of course, he used to take a head okay. in that.
Sure.
And, definitely he'll sing. चित चोरा यशोदा के बाल नवनीत चोर गो चोरा यशोदा के बाल नवनीत चोर गोपाल चित्त चोरा यशोदा के बाल नवनीत चोर गोपाल गोपाल Gopal, Gopal, Govardhana, Dhara Gopal, 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 Govardhana, Dhara Dhara Gopal, 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 Govardhana, Dhara Gopal, Chitta Chora Yashoda Ke Baal, नवनीत चोर गोपाल 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 गोवर्धन धर गोपाल 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 Gopal, Govardhana Dhara Gopal. यशोदा के बार नवनीत चोर गोपाल।
Hey Ram, uncle, can I be selfish to say we need a few more interviews to happen? A couple more songs, uncle, please.
Today?
One more. Yeah, if you, one more.
Okay. रक्ष रक्ष जगदीश्वरा रक्ष रक्ष जगदीश्वरा पूर्तिपुरी परमेश्वरा पूर्तिपुरी परमेश्वरा पाहि पाहि परमेश्वरा पाहि पाहि परमेश्वरा देहि देहि तव पद सेवा मुदम देहि तव पद सेवा रक्ष रक्ष जगदीश्वरा पूर्तिपुरी परमेश्वरा पाहि पाहि परमेश्वरा पाहि पाहि परमेश्वरा देहि देहि तव पद सेवा मुदम देहि देहि तव पद सेवा रक्ष रक्ष जगदीश्वरा पूर्तिपुरी परमेश्वरा।
Sai Ram, uncle. Sai Ram, thank you so much, uncle. Thank you, thank you. Thanks to Swami. I think for all of us from the current generation where the singing comes with the technicality of singing and bringing in variations, what you bring is a direct connect. The moment you open, there is that connect with Swami that comes in the divinity from the heart and the music that comes. And we are blessed today to listen to you. I think you might say that you do not speak so much, but whatever you have spoken have been so precise, especially the significance of bhajans that you highlighted. I hope it reverberates in everybody's heart and minds every time we have an opportunity to listen to bhajan wherever it is. We know that Swami is there coming in and trying to say, hello, I'm here. So as long as we realize that it is Swami coming and talking to us, when we connect to the bhajan, that is our connect with Swami each day. And we are only blessed because for those who have been watching the series, I think a few weeks ago, we heard about Swami's visit to Calicut, about how the professor there, after that, he moved to Bangalore. And Swami now comes, talks about, I mean, today we get to know about the people who sang the bhajans when the inauguration happened in Calicut in those visits. So I guess this whole satsang is all about each one of us connecting to those who have had the blessings of being there in the early days, forming that unwavering devotion and belief in Swami, and that it helps us today to circumvent whatever challenges that come along our path and be inspired by these Mahanubhavas who come and share their experiences to us, to reiterate that Swami is in our hearts. It's all the love that matters amongst us. And whatever we are today is nothing but His grace. With that, thank you so much, Uncle, and I'm looking forward to the continuation. As I would say, it's a continuation of today's satsang that is going to happen next week, and I'm looking forward to hearing Haridas Uncle's continue where you left off, and I hope we get to hear more of your bhajans in possible satsangs to come, so that all of us have the bliss of listening to that resonation, the resonance that reverberated the halls when Bose speakers and you know, all those special paraphernalia and microphones did not exist. It takes us back to that time to relive those wonderful moments that all of you have had the fortune. And this morning, Ravi Shankar Anna was saying that his first visit while controlling the mics, he still remembers you all singing the bhajan that he highlighted to you earlier today. So this whole satsang series.
Venkat Bhaiya, I want to tell him.
Anna, that, don't call me Bhaiya. Bhaiya is
I just want to say that more than 50 years ago, what I heard from Sheradi, same touches I am hearing today. Touches are exactly same. So nice.
Absolutely.
And I heard you singing that Sambho Shiva Shankara.
Yeah.
That song, you know, so with high pitch, you know, Shambho Shiva Shankara.
Yeah.
That song also I thought he would sing. So nice. Thank you, Sai Ram.
Thank you. And praying to Swami that this series, which started off as a study circle of our center, by Swami's grace, we are entering the 90th week in a row where we have not missed hearing. What started off as alumni satsangs, it moved from alumni to yesteryear. Last week we had Vijayamma Garu. So we had about 4 weeks of Anyata Sharanam Nasti series. So this is happening with this infinite grace. We don't have a plan. As I say, this satsang is all of us sitting in the porch of our house, looking at the moon and seeing Swami in the moon and reflecting on how beautiful his light has showered on us in our lives. And today's satsang is no different from that. Lots of learning for all of us. Looking forward to more of this happening. As I say, I have no clue who the speaker is. Swami knows. This time I have a clue who the speaker is. So all of you, looking forward to having you all next Sunday, same time, praying to Swami to keep everyone safe and showering his grace in every moment of our lives. With that, we'll finish with Samastha.
Thank you so much for the opportunity you have given to me. And let us all pray together that our life should go as per the expectation of Swami. That is the main important thing. Maximum time, you know, you can pray. I mean, pray is not, Swami always says, you know, sitting in the puja room and sitting for half an hour or 1 hour, that is not the thing. Awareness, always, you know, if you are thinking that God is with me, that nearness with the God, that is more important. Let us all pray. You see, for that also, Swami's grace is required. So let Swami grace all of us to have that awareness in all of us and do more sevas, more bhajans, more satsangs and everything. We'll conclude the session.
We'll finish with three samastaloka sankar.
Yeah, yes.
Samastaloka sukino bhavantu. Samastaloka sukino bhavantu. Samastaloka sukino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Jai bolo Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba Ji ki.
Jai.
Sai Ram, looking forward to seeing all of you next Sunday. Until then, Sai Ram, stay safe with his grace. Sai Ram.
Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram.